Elvis from the land of the chill. If I can't warm you, baby, nobody will. A genuine Canadian man. Strong and free, that's the true north, and baby, that's me. I'll salute you as long as need be. A genuine Canadian man.
Well, good morning. So it is around, what is it, 6:45 on the first day here in Anaheim. And it looks like it's going to be a nice day, clear skies up above here, the palm trees are blowing, and oh, that's lovely, palm trees. And right now we're sitting on the corner of Harbor Boulevard, and we're actually, the hotel we're staying at is the Desert Palm, Desert Palm's Hotels and Suites here in Anaheim. And we're really lucky. We're there's a Walgreens right across the street. There's also a CVS pharmacy. We discovered last night there's a 7-Eleven right outside our front door. And then across the way there's a Subway and a pizza place. We didn't go to this. We'll get any food last night. It was by the time I got to bed, it was probably around 2 o'clock in the morning. And just to get in a little bit of a wide shot on it, and it looks like this, sounds like this hotel's been here for a little while, but it's a very nice hotel right here. And we're apparently only, we haven't gone there yet, but we're only about a 13-minute walk from the main gates of Disneyland. So yeah, so this is where we're staying, we're gonna be, right now everyone is still sleeping. There was, again, we came in pretty late. There was a bit of delay in the flights that came in. I guess it was a flight out of Toronto that came in late, and that which pushed us late, and so on and so forth. But again, we are here now, and I'll be going back upstairs, see if I can wake anybody up, and see what time we can start moving there. And otherwise, maybe I'll explore this area for a little bit, and I see there's a coffee house across the way, and again, there's a lot of other places. Actually, you know what? We got a couple minutes here, so I'm gonna take a bit of a walk right now, and we're gonna have a bit of a walk and just see where we're at right now, and what the neighborhood here is like around Disney. And already people coming in, starting their days this morning. And so, as I said, here's the 7-Eleven that I mentioned that we found here last night. And I found my favorite drink of all time here at the 7-Eleven. It was Yoo-Hoo. I'm so happy about the Yoo-Hoo. It looks like we got also, it wasn't open late, but there is a little A-Mart here. So another little market. Another little market here. And then, again, there's the Walgreens, the CVS, pharmacy. And as you can see, I can see, in this area, we have the Wyndham Hotel, the Hyatt House, the, what is it, Suites. There's hotels on each corner of this area. I see a Blaze Pizza off in the distance. Oh, Starbucks. Melissa will like that. And if I look down this way, some more. This road here, this is the road we're talking about. This one, actually, just going down this way, this is where the way to get to Disneyland. Disneyland is probably just a distance. I won't walk there just yet. I'll wait for everybody else. But again, and then there's another sort of themed hotel over across the way. And what have we got? Brewberry Cafe and a few places, a souvenir place across the street. So yeah, this is a really great location. And for the hotel, the amount that we paid, this was actually a great location. I'm very happy that we discovered it. So I'm gonna head back inside and I'm gonna see how everybody is getting up, and until then and hopefully we'll get a bit of breakfast before we head out to the Disneyland Resort. So a little note, unfortunately, got back to the hotel room. Melissa wasn't feeling well, so she's gonna actually stay back for a little while, and hopefully she'll make it out later today. But unfortunately, she wasn't feeling well at all, so she's gonna rest up and get some well-needed sleep, because she got a bit of a cold and gonna have just rest for the next hour. So hopefully we'll check on her and see if she can come out a little bit later this morning. All right, so we are finally walking over towards the theme parks, and today we are going to be going to California Adventure. This is our first day, but as we're walking, we're passing it by. Here's Candy Cane Inns across the street. There's Castle Inn and Suites. As earlier mentioned, there's like the hotel. They have like four hotels on each corner. So right now, as I said, unfortunately, Melissa wasn't feeling too well to start off with. But we have Star, Sabrina, and Zaylee. And then, so we're gonna walk. And this is our walk. I'm gonna keep recording here for a bit. And you'll start hearing me tiring out a bit, but you know, that's just the way it goes. But definitely a nice walk from the hotel to the front doors of Disneyland, which, according to the when we booked the hotel, was about 13 minutes of a walk, and it looks like that it's still probably will be about that. You can see here, traffic is just nuts. Like, traffic has been like this all morning long, right from the get-go. When I came out earlier and it was still dark, traffic already was nice and busy, and even now it's just continuing on of how busy it is. And then, oh, this is sort of interesting. As I'm walking by, there's these little sort of different little stars. Like, here's Gene Autry, Yorba Family Pioneers. That's sort of neat. It's something different, probably from famous to sponsors. So right now we're just at the sort of the, looks like an intersection going in, and here there's the Grand Legacy at the park, and we're gonna stop here right now. And I think I'll pause the video, because I don't have much to say right now. But we'll say something more, and we'll
I'll join back up when we get to the front gate of the park. Okay, so we're now right at the main, or the main entranceway into Disneyland, and still got a little bit of a walk, but as you can see here, according to the signs, there's the theme parks, and downtown Disney is off in that direction. So we're gonna go through the gates here. So we're not in Disneyland proper, but you can actually see up ahead in a second here, once we get past these really nice big hedges, you can see bits and pieces of Disneyland over on that side. And then there's the monorail track. And here's a bunch of, looks like a mess load of buses are in this area, which is really nice for if you're staying further away. But again, we're so close. Like we weren't actually that far from the gates when I in the last video clip. But we're just gonna keep walking. And as I said, there's a mess load of buses here, so I don't know exactly what we got here. Security screening checkpoint. So make sure if you come to Disneyland, you don't have any firearms, knives, explosives, or any other weapons. And as you can see, there's a bit of security here, which is fine. You know, that's, we want to keep everybody safe and happy while visiting the magical kingdom. And yeah, here we go. So here's the up ahead. We're going to be going through the gate, so I gotta get my digital ticket out. But again, today we're going to be going to California Adventure, and that will be our adventure for today. So we've now made it through this. We went to the security checkpoint, and you know, they're just want to make sure we're safe, you know, because again, but now we're sort of at the cusp of coming into the park here. Like again, we're going on the side of California Adventure, and but this is what's really cool about this. The two parks are basically connected. There's the, and everything is, as we can see, is Disney themed. Even the park benches are Mickey Mouse benches, and then here's some of the old gates, I think. That's but yeah, so if we look here, we're again sort of in the central area, and so tomorrow we will be going on that side there, which is Disneyland itself. But for today, we're going on this side, which as we can see is Disney California Adventure. All right, so we are in California Adventure right now, and we're gonna start off walking down Buena Vista Street. And there's all kinds of, like, there's all the stores here that the girls have sort of missed a little bit. Well, Sabrina found something already. But, and as you can see here, everything is right now Halloween themed, because we are here on October 30th. And again, we can see here, this is that nice little main street for the California Adventure. And there's as you can see, there's different stores, there's different food places. I guess that's like Yeah, there's all kinds of different things here in this little park area. Oh, and everything looks like it has been all decorated for the Halloween theme. For example, here we have the Headless Horseman from the Disney film with Ichabod Crane. And then even with the pumpkin there. Here's like one of the trolleys that is here that we might go for a ride on the trolley at some point, just to, as it's just going through here. And again, there's all kinds of different stuff in this first area. We've only just touched the surface of what's here at the park. Here's actually a really neat. Here's a statue of Walt Disney and of Mickey. So it's. And then here's. Oh, I love that. And there's the bats coming out of the tower here. And we're gonna. And oh, wow, we're looking at down this way. Here, the girls want to. Go down, and we're gonna go that way in a minute. They're gonna disappear on me pretty soon, but we're just gonna, I'll follow up right away. Okay, so we're gonna go down this road here. I'm not certain exactly what the road is called, but again, there's all these different.
Can Star and I go ahead?
Yeah, all right, go ahead, yeah. So this is like a gorgeous sort of scenery for here in the California Adventure. Like it's sort of a Hollywood old time. We got, let's see, Disney Junior Dance Party, Off the Page, Accessories, etc. Yeah, so definitely a lot of places for souvenirs. And then, okay, there's up ahead the trolley again. And then Mickey's PhilharMagic. Looks like sort of a restaurant of some sort. But yeah, this looks like almost like a back lot, Hollywood back lot here with all the different buildings and even the big scenery up ahead there. And oh yeah, see, and then there's Hollywood Studios. So definitely something, big shout out to Hollywood here in the Los Angeles area. So we're going in to So this is for Monsters Inc. So this is the first ride we're going to go on. So this is officially our first ride at California Adventure. So, are you guys excited? Yeah. And I think what we're going to do, I'm not going to really record much of the ride itself, but we're going to just wanted to record this as one of the rides that we're going into first, and then the big long sort of lineup around. And oh, look at that! Something that no one ever sees anymore. payphones. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead, so we're gonna go do the taxis, and we're gonna go in. So so we'll see when we after the ride. All right, so we just came out of our first ride there of the theme parks. So what's your assessment, Twinkle?
Good.
How about you?
It was good.
Yeah.
So cool. I ended up crying at the end, but that's because I was just that emotional. It was
really cool. All right. Well, sounds like, I'll say I enjoyed the ride here. Oh, wait. There we go. There's me. And so I enjoyed the ride too. This is a fun ride, definitely. And just a nice, easy, quick, dark ride. But we're going to go see now what else we are going to find. What's our next ride? Okay. So we're coming to see, this is, I guess, the Guardians of the Galaxy ride. As you can see, it is quite big. Like, look at the people here. Look at how big this thing is. Wow, this is just amazing. So let's look. Oh, look at that over there. There's the gate to Stark Aeronautics. There's some treats here. And then here's the thing for Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout.
Situation, resume your tour as soon as possible. However, your wait time has significantly increased. We have to resume your tour soon and sincerely apologize for inconvenience. We will try to send you cooperation in advance.
So, Zay, which one are we going on now?
Yeah.
I don't know the language. Honestly. Which planet is that from? So we're now entering into the Radiator Springs, and we can all see all the different here's Luigi's right here. And Flo's V8 Cafe. Here's the intersection. Oh, there's the statue there from the movie. So do you ever think we'd come to Radiator Springs?
It looks like it would be great.
Trunk or treat. But definitely they have done a whole wonderful job of the Halloween displays for all of this. Like, we're sure to come here a little bit later at nighttime when it's all lit up. We're gonna see how this place looks. I have a feeling this whole area is gonna look just wonderful.